You've got the creator of the universe hanging on a cross who's going to be dying in a matter of minutes, and he's going to be placed in a cave in the very earth that he created. The angels, it was called the scandal of the incarnation. When they found out what God was going to do, become a man, they said, are you kidding? God is going to become a man? What is he thinking? This is the scandal of the incarnation. And then he took it even further, the scandal of the cross, because not only did he become a human being, but he went all the way to the cross and died for us. And God, who had created all of this and made our bodies, took a body and let it be killed and buried in the very earth which he had created. And the angels, I'm sure they just turned away and said, oh, goodness, why does he love these people so much? They sin against him. They rebel against him. They don't pay attention to him. Why does he love them so much to do this for them? And so the whole idea of the nature reacting, can you imagine the all of creation sees this happening and said, he created us and now he's going to be dying here. And so the earthquakes, the ground shakes, and even when you're at Calvary at the Church of the Holy Sepulchre, you can see the rock still at the top of Calvary where they're all cracked and where they broke because of this crucifixion. And it says the sky turned dark. The sun couldn't even stand to look at what was going on, and the clouds obliterated the sun, and all of nature reacted and rebelled against what was happening to its creator.
Wow. Powerful.
Steve, somebody just texted me. I just want to make sure, because probably other people have this question, that you mentioned that in Genesis chapter 22, verse 2, that's the first time the word love is used in the Bible, right?
Yes.
Okay, just
that's
to make
the
sure.
First time the word love is used in the Bible. Go to my blog today, catholicconvert.com, scroll down one or two, and I've got an article about that, and I also show some of the parallelism that we're talking about between Abraham and God the Father. And by the way, the second time the word love is used in the Bible is related to Isaac when he has his wife, and it says he loves his wife and takes her into his tent, and he marries her, and that is a picture of Jesus after he goes back to heaven from the sacrifice. Abraham takes his son Isaac back home but then God takes his son back home to heaven, sends a servant to find a bride for his son, which is the Holy Spirit being sent to the earth to find a bride for his son, brings the bride back, and it says that Isaac loved his wife and married her and loved her. Second time the word love is used, and it's the same God the Father sends his Holy Spirit down to find a bride for his son, and eventually he's going to bring the church back to heaven, and we're going to have the great bride wedding feast of the Lamb. And so those are the two times the word love is used. One in relation to God the Father, related to the love of his son, and then to Isaac, the picture of Jesus loving his church.
Wow, Steve, I've got a question after the break. It's going to be a good one. Everybody's going to want to understand this. We know that the temple, the curtain in the temple was torn from top to bottom. What's the significance of that? Why wasn't it torn from bottom to top? And when we